What's up guys, welcome back to another video on dental photography. Now, since we released our three-part photography series, we've had a lot of questions about using mirrorless cameras like these for dental photography. In this video, I'm going to talk you through a budget setup like this one and an advanced setup like this one, all the settings that you need for your mirrorless cameras and the flashes. Let's get into it. Alright guys, so here we have the two different setups. This is the budget setup and this is the one that's a little bit more advanced and more expensive. But let's start with the budget setup. And I call it budget, but it's just basically the one that's cheaper in the mirrorless world. This is the cheapest setup you're most likely going to be able to get. And I appreciate it's still more expensive than DSLRs out there. So now with this setup, you have a Sony A6000 body with a Nissan MF18 ring flash. And for the lens, I've gone for a Samyang 100mm macro lens, which is actually half the price of the Sony lens that you have on the other setup. Now, the main disadvantage of this lens compared to the other one is that it doesn't have autofocus, which doesn't matter too much because you should only be using manual focus when doing dental photography anyways. The only time I can kind of think of using autofocus is when I'm taking portrait shots. But even then, you can still use the manual focus on this lens. It just might take you an extra few seconds to find focus. Now, this setup comes to around £1,000 or $1,500. And as I mentioned, I know it's not cheap, but it's the cheaper option in this case. So in the more advanced setup here, I have a Sony A6400 with the Sony 90mm macro lens and the Mirrorless twin flashes. And all of this is mounted on the owl bracket. And these are some of the diffusers that I made myself. You can check out the equipment video that I made before to see how I made them. This setup is more expensive and is around £2,200 or $2,500. But there are a few main differences between these two setups. The first minor difference is between the Sony A6000 and the Sony A6400 camera bodies. As I explained in the first video of the photography series, the main advantage of using these mirrorless cameras for dental photography is the focus peaking. Now, the focus peaking is when the camera highlights the edges of the areas which you're focusing on. So you don't have to look through the viewfinder to make sure you're in focus. You can just move your camera in and out until you see the dots show around the edges of the teeth, and then you can just take your shot. The focus peaking gives you more confidence because when you see those dots on the tooth, you know you're in focus, you're not going to doubt yourself. And it also means you don't have to take off your loops, which is especially annoying when wearing those massive FFP3 masks. So to get to the point, the differences between these two cameras when it comes to focus peaking is the colors that are available. The A6000 has white, red and yellow, but the A6400 also has blue. The reason blue is so good is that we rarely see anything in the mouth that's blue. So when I have the focus peaking on the A6400 with the blue, it's very easy to see the dots. But on the A6000, you have to set it to red, which can be more difficult to see because the gingiva and the tongue are also red. Now, I know this might sound very minor, but it can actually make a big difference. But one of the biggest differences is the twin flash on the advanced setup because of the stronger modeling light. The modeling light is the light which is always on when you're preparing to take photos, and it lights up the subject and makes it easier for you to see the teeth and get focus. The one on the twin flash is much stronger, and so you get to see much clearer lines and dots of focus peaking. The modeling light helps especially with posterior shots because it brightens up the area, so it's much easier to tell if you're in focus or not. However, with this flash, you need to make sure you mount it on an owl bracket like this one. I tried using it with the mount that comes with the flash, but I struggled because the posterior shots were looking too dark. The bracket lets you bring the flashes very close to the lens and more forward, so the light can reach all the way to the back of the mount. Now, the last difference I wanted to mention with these two setups is the lenses. The Sony lens, as mentioned before, has the autofocus, but it also has superior optics, so the colors are more accurate and look more natural. Have a look on the screen at the comparison. Both shots were taken with the A6400 and the twin flash setup, but I just changed the lenses. The skin tones and colors on the Sony lens are much better. As you can see, the Samyang lens tends to give a yellow hue to the pictures. This could be fixed with changing the white balance from the flash to a custom white balance, which I'll show you how to set up later, but the colors are still not as good as the Sony, as you can see. Now, I know some people might think that these minor advantages for the more expensive setup just isn't worth the extra £1,000 or $1,000. And for most of you, it probably isn't worth it. But the reason I like it so much is that it means I can be really quick at taking consistent, higher quality photos. So I end up taking more photos every single day when I'm at work compared to a DSLR setup or this ring flash setup with the weaker modeling light. But I know this comes at a premium price tag. Before I move on to the camera settings, I'd really appreciate it if you guys gave this video a like. It really helps our channel grow and reach more people. Thank you. So now let's move on to the actual settings on the camera. So the first setting you should change is the aspect ratio. It's on the first page of the first tab. Change it to 3x2. This lets you then change the image size to 24 megapixels. If you're on the A6400, you should also change the JPEG quality to extra fine. The next setting is the monitor brightness. You can find it on the briefcase menu tab at the end, and it's the first option. You want to change it to sunny weather. This will significantly brighten up the monitor and help you see much better when focusing, especially in dark areas of the mouth. Next is the focus peaking settings. On the A6000, it's on the second tab on the second page, and on the A6400, it's on the first tab on the 13th page. If you're using the Nissin Ring Flash, set the peaking level to high, or if you're using the Mirrorless Twin Flash, set it to mid. And if you're on the A6000, set the color to red, and if you're on the A6400, set it to blue. Next, you want to turn the dial on your camera and go into manual mode. Then from here, click the function button to open up the quick settings. Change the drive mode to single. If you have the Sony lens, set the white balance to flash. But if you have the Samyang lens, scroll down to the custom white balance, which is labeled C temp/filter, and set the temperature to 5800 Kelvin. This will compensate for the yellow hue of the Samyang lens that we talked about before. Then click the FN button to leave the menu. Now you want to set your ISO, shutter speed, and aperture. The settings on the screen is what I have found works best for taking intraoral photographs, and now your camera settings are ready. But before you carry on, you should actually save these settings to a preset so it's much quicker for you to get access to them. Once you have all the settings ready, click the menu button and find the memory option. On the A6000, it's on the first tab on the 7th page, and on the A6400, it's on the first tab on the 4th page. Click on it and it will show you 3 different pages, and you can select which one you want to register these settings to. In this case, pick number 1 and click enter. Now those settings we have just set are in the memory recall page number 1. Now the way to get to these settings every time is by turning the dial on your camera to MR, which is memory recall. When you do that, it brings back up the same menu and lets you choose between 1, 2, and 3. In this case, you're going to select 1 and click OK. And now we have all the settings that we want. This is useful because you can always accidentally change settings here and there. But before I take any intraoral photographs, I turn my dial into MR and select page 1, and I always know that the settings will be correct for my photos. On the second page of my MR settings, I've set my portrait settings, and you can do the same. So now let's move on to the flash settings. For the Nissin Ring Flash, I recommend having the flash on TTL when taking portraits, and have it on manual mode for taking intraoral photographs. For the manual settings, I recommend setting it to quarter power. This will be the correct setting most of the time. What I would recommend is when you take photos, take a shot, look at it. If it's too bright, bring it down to 1/8, and if it's too dark, bring it up to a half. And remember, always have your modeling light on when taking photos. With this flash, you turn it on by holding down the set button. Now, for the Mirrorless Twin Flash, you turn it on by holding the power button. The flash has two modes, slave mode and master mode, and you can switch between them by pressing the power button. You want to enter master mode. Here, you can see you have 3 groups you can set. To set the settings, click the group button. A will be highlighted. Then press in the scroll wheel to enter the group. Then turn the scroll wheel until you change the mode to M, which is for manual. Then click in the scroll wheel again to move to the next setting, which is power. Turn the scroll wheel to change the power to 1/1, which is full power. Then click the wheel again, which lets you pick the focal length of your lens and change it to 135 millimeters. Now do the same for group B, but change the power to a half. And then for group C, change the flash mode to TTL, 0 and 135 millimeters. As you can see on the screen. With this setup, 99% of the time I use A. The only time I use group C, which is the automatic TTL mode, is when I'm trying to get pictures of crowns or dentures outside the mouth. Now, the speed lights connect to the transmitter automatically when you turn them on, and you can see they display which group they're on. Because I always use group A, I just turn them on and leave it there. But you can change the group using the button here. And before taking photos, click this button to turn on the modeling light and use the scroll wheel to make sure it's on 12, which is full power. When I'm taking anterior shots, I have the flashes set wide apart like this. And when I'm taking posterior shots, I bring them closer to the middle and in front of the lens. Again, this will let more light reach the back of the mouth. And that's it for all the settings. I cover the actual techniques for taking all the shots in the third video of the photography series that we did. So if you haven't watched that video, make sure you check it out. I'll have a link to all the videos in the description, and all the products that I mentioned today as well will be in the blog post. If you guys found this video useful, I'd really appreciate it if you gave the video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. If you have any questions, make sure you pop them down in the comments, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Thank you guys, and see you in the next video.